go for
we
it.
Didn't talk about Tom Hanks.
Yeah. I literally told Kyle, I was like, we have in the podcast, we have to talk about Tom Hanks because we're all focusing on Austin Butler and we have to talk about him. Yeah.
Go for it.
I did not like Tom Hanks.
I knew you were going to say that. I knew you were going to give us a hot take. Okay. Break it down for us.
Okay. I could not get past seeing Tom Hanks. And the accent was pretty ridiculous. And I know that this guy had a fairly ridiculous accent. But I went and did a lot of research and watched a lot of videos and stuff. And the guy's accent wasn't that crazy. He actually did sound a little Southern more than he did, like, from the Netherlands. But, like, Tom Hanks' accent was crazy. I couldn't get past the makeup. I wish they would have chosen someone else, honestly. And I don't think it's Tom Hanks' fault, because Tom Hanks is phenomenal.
Yes.
Yeah. No, I agree. For me, it wasn't, like, incredible, where I'm like, oh my gosh, it's like him and Mr. Rogers again, like Beautiful Day in the Neighborhood. Nor was it like that was terribly bad, but I get you. Like, the makeup is obvious. I think for me, I don't think you really notice it in the scenes where, like, it's him. For me, it's noticeable when they're doing like the hospital scenes. Like, I think it's like the first shot, one of the first shots in the movie where you see him. And it's just like, yikes, you know, like that's
he's like walking through the casino.
Yeah. It's just like, yikes. That's crazy. And you're right. I mean, the voice, everyone talked about that. Even when the trailers came out, his voice, the actual voice of Tom Parker was not like that at all. It wasn't like that. Some of us paint them out to be the villain. You know, it wasn't like this.
The villain of this story.
It definitely was, I guess, his choice, or, you know, I don't know. You know, I got to do some more research on that, but I agree with you a little bit there.
All right. So I think that Tom Hanks had a very interesting responsibility in this movie, because I will argue that this movie is, yes, about Elvis's life, but more than it's about Elvis's life, it's about Elvis's life through the perspective in the hands of Tom Parker. And so I would say that his responsibility was to create, more so than Austin Butler had to create the character of Elvis, Tom Hanks had to create a character and a villain as Tom Parker. That Tom Hanks had to create that character, and he had to make this person and create this person that was also pretty, like, secretive and, like, also, like, very secretive, actually. And, like, pretty, like, we don't know a lot about him. That was kind of the running thing. Like, who is this guy? Where'd he come from? He's just bossing around the biggest guy in the world. So, I don't know. For me, I didn't like Tom Hanks as Tom Parker, but I do respect the fact that he had a huge responsibility in this movie to create a character that literally has only ever been rumored about, and, like, there's conspiracy theories about this guy, and like, he just, there's not a lot to really, like, run off of with him. You know what I mean?
That's yeah. Well, you make a good point too, because Baz Luhrmann is a very theatrical style of directing. And the accent kind of reminds me of Robert Pattinson in, he played that French prince in with opposite of Timothy Chalamet in that one movie about King Henry. I think it was called King Henry. Anyways, everyone was critiquing. I just said Robert Pattinson's accent, because it was like extremely, like, almost like a caricature of a French person, like super put on. But it was more of a style choice. They were talking about it in interviews. We're like, well, no, we wanted to make fun of this character. And so, like, if that's the direction that Baz was trying to go for, where they were trying to take this man and make a bigger character out of him, then that makes sense.
Yeah.
And I didn't think of that until now, so.
Yeah. I did tell Kyle before, like, when the trailer started coming out, I told him I really wanted to see them talk about the conspiracy theories around him. And I was hoping, but, like, part of me didn't think they would at all. I was kind of like, yeah, I think they're just going to, like, show that he was the manager. They're going to, like, hint at the fact that maybe he was, like, ripping off a little bit. But I was pleasantly surprised about how transparent they were in the movie about what a monster this guy actually was. Even bringing up, like, Holland and bringing up the fact that he didn't have a passport and the whole, like, why didn't he let Elvis travel thing. I didn't think any of that was going to come out in the movie. So I was pleasantly surprised to see them make a huge deal about that in that one scene where Elvis, like, calls him out. But also just, like, in the closing credits, too, at the end, talking about his financial abuse and stuff.
Yeah, yeah. See, I see it from a different perspective. I kind of feel like the only reason why Tom Hanks was in this movie is in some way the studio probably wanted someone credible. Because this is kind of a risky move. It's a risky move making an Elvis movie. Again, like I said, there's not many biopics. This is the first legitimate time that a studio has come out here and made a biopic. And so, you know, not only are you giving it to, I wouldn't say like Baz Luhrmann is a dicey director, but it's just, you know, it's a hit or miss, I think, box office wise for Baz Luhrmann. And, you know, you're experimenting with a young, unpopular actor such as like Austin Butler. And so when you get a guy like Tom Hanks, you're like, oh, you know, that turns heads. You're like, oh, Tom Hanks. Okay. I can, because Tom Hanks can act out of anything. He can do anything. Yeah. You can put him in anything. Yeah. And I think as ridiculous as the accent is or, you know, what it is or whatever, you know, it's pretty legit. Like he's the heartbeat of the movie. And I think as a studio and as a director, you need someone to carry the movie like that. Because you got all these other experimental parts that you really don't know if the audience is going to catch along, but everyone loves Tom Hanks.
Yeah.
You kidding me?
Yeah.
Everyone loves Tom Hanks. You can't hate on him.
You make such a good point. And like, if Tom Hanks wasn't in it, I'm curious if it was like a different actor that wasn't as well-liked or well-known, I'm curious if it would have gotten less views in the first box office, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Weirdly enough, Tom Hanks is kind of that guy at the moment. He's such a legend. I think you can put him in anything, and you know, he can, because they have Disney has a new movie coming out. It's a remake of Pinocchio, which is just ridiculous. But Tom Hanks is in it. But then again, now you're turning your head. Now it's like, oh, Tom Hanks is in it. Like, maybe, you know.
I'm just gonna hear Woody.
It's a smart move. It's a smart move, and it's not a bad move either. Like, you know, Tom Hanks really, he has a lot of screen time. He's narrating the movie. And I think that's probably one of my other problems, too, is, like, the movie kind of has a hard time of what it really wants to be, in the sense that, okay, you want to tell the life of Elvis beginning to end, but also the movie's narrated by the Colonel. And so, like, where's the perspective of the movie coming from? Is it him or, you know, is it Elvis? Because there's time spent with Elvis and whatnot. But, I mean, that's a minor gripe.
But I think that's intentional. I think that's so intentional. Because if you're – this is what – I think that's intentional to make people feel that way. Like, whose story is it really? Is it Tom Parker's story or is it Elvis's story? I think that's intentional. I think it is. I think it's intentional because that's the legacy that Tom Parker wanted to leave. He wanted to leave that legacy that it was him that created Elvis, even though it was Sam Phillips. He wanted to create it that it was him that created Elvis. It was him that made everything about Elvis famous and that he was just like this little pawn that he moved around. But then Elvis's family was fighting to keep him and like the forefront. It was intentional. Boz, you knew what you were doing.
Yeah, because even in his like dialogue and narration, he never denies being manipulative or being selfish or whatever. He just talks about how he made Elvis. The only time he does is when he's talking to Elvis. The only time he denies is when he's talking to Elvis and his family. This is interesting.
Yes.
It is interesting.
See, and this is why this is a good movie.